April 5th, 2021. A nice New Yorker gave away a bunch of endlers. I'm very happy to adopt them. I have a couple aquariums that are fully prepared months in advance for fish to be moved in. And I actually used one of those aquariums as a temporary house for rescued wild minnows. Well, it was back in December 2020. Check my livestream videos for more details. Now let's get my endlers out of the bag. First, I put them all in one deep plastic plate. There is more than a dozen of them here. All look healthy. Wait about 30 minutes for the water in the plate to get to the same temperature as in the aquariums. Now let's move the fish into their new homes. I use a turkey baster or a large pipette to move fish less than 2 cm long. And any size fish can be moved with a fish net. I count 11 males and 4 females. Let's split them into 3 groups of 5 fish. 1-2 females and 3-4 males in each group. These 3 liter jars with a diameter of about 15 cm are suitable for fish up to 5 cm long. Endlers of half that size should be fine here. And here is an 8 liter vase with a diameter of about 18 cm. This pretty aquarium garden belongs to my son. 1 female and 4 males go here. It's a couple years old sustainable aquarium garden. I see some filamentous algae here. Well, my kid is going to take care of these 5 endlers. And I'm going to take care of endlers in my 3 liter sustainable aquariums. Endlers start exploring their new homes. Noticeably, endlers mostly swim in a group the way schooling fish do. Initially, they stay at the bottom. I guess fish feel safe at the bottom and there should be a lot of live food for them to pick on. Male endlers have bright colors that make it easy to distinguish them from plain colored females. Also, males have a stick-shaped underbelly fin and females have a fan-shaped underbelly fin. Endlers are very playful and swift-moving fish. Males compete against each other all day long trying to get female attention. Here you can see a female nibbles on a plant while watching males compete for her attention. Females are dominant in endlers society. The most energetic male gets the most attention from females and from competitors. Males compete all the time. Wow, that was sort of last male stance of fireball action. Endlers' swift movements fill the aquarium with life and actions that make a pretty sight to watch. Among the females, one female, the most dominant, stands out as a queen. And females fend off males on a whim. Here you can see the queen chase away another female. Removing old aquatic plants from aquariums is important for preventing algae blooms. I do it every month or so. Check my videos about algae control for more details about it. The land plants grown with roots and water in my aquarium gardens also help keep aquariums clean. So I don't have to and I do not change water in my aquariums at all. And the plant reduces water evaporation. I dry the spare aquatic plants with snails and other creatures caught in them to feed them back to fish. In my sustainable aquarium gardens, fish eat only what grows in the aquariums. And there are plenty of plants and creatures for my fish. Check my videos for more details about fish feeding. I use only natural indirect sunlight for all aquariums with fish. No air pumps or man-made filters. It takes a couple days for plants to air dry at normal room temperature. And then I just crush the dry plants with my fingers. The food is ready. I give my endlers a pinch of these flakes 2-3 times a week. It is a supplemental feeding in addition to what they nibble on the aquariums all day long. And there is a lot of them in my aquariums to choose from. There are scats, blackworms, sea shrimp and plants to feed on. As I mentioned before, I don't change water at all. So I add dechlorinated water to the level once every week or two. And that is basically all to speak of aquarium care. Also, I like to add blooming flowers to my aquarium gardens. It makes things even prettier. I'm still learning about endlers. It will take years to see if endlers are suitable for sustainable aquarium gardens the way my dwarf guppies are. So far things look good and promising. For breeding purpose, I moved my endlers into 3 aquariums, keeping 1 female with 2 males in each tank. May 21st, 2021. Endlers in the 8-liter aquarium of my kid marked an important milestone. Let's see if you can spot it. Yes, here are 3 I've been talking about. Endlers had babies. Life is beautiful and sustainable aquarium gardens are just the right way to go about it. I will keep you updated. Have fun and happy aquarium gardens!